Good morning and welcome here to the first weekly webinar, Digital for Marketing for Lawyers. It's a great pleasure to have you on board on this Friday morning. Then let's get started with the agenda, and that is an overview also for going forward. So the idea is this is a weekly webinar. And I want to cover in each of the webinars one topic briefly, just about 10, 12 minutes, maybe 15 minutes. And then I want to make time available for question and answers. So whatever you have in that area, I would do a very, very quick introduction, personal introduction. This week, we'll talk about one critical item, which is mobile optimized websites. And again, it's just roughly 15 minutes, maybe a little bit less. I want to have really that you have something to take away, think about, and then also give you the opportunity for an open question and answer session. So this is kind of the structure of the webinar. And yeah, let's get into it. Very brief introduction. My name is Michael Alf. I was working 12 years with Capgemini in the consulting, IT, business development, project management, and account management area. And they negotiated numerous deals, contracts, agreements, always with the legal professionals on both sides of the table, both globally in Europe, internationally, but also then locally here in Australia. And then I was 1.5 years with Asciano, more on the project management side, and again negotiated deals as and contracts as a buyer that side. So yeah, from that side, both sides of the table. Now I'm CEO and founder of Digital for Lawyers, so a digital marketing agency working with law firms to help streamline, optimize, and automate the marketing activities, and therefore reduce the spend and get a higher return on investment. And I'm also the publisher and founding editor of the Modern Executive Technology Career and Work-Life Balance, and that's exclusively in the Apple Newsstand. And I'm working at the moment right now on a special issue for the legal industry, which makes some good progress. I have some very interesting contributors, and I really look forward to sharing that. It will take a couple of weeks still, but I'm very excited about sharing that. And that will be obviously at some stage at least one webinar what we are touching on. And so watch out on that one. So that's myself. Let's quickly introduce you to the letter of awesomeness of digital marketing. And I would like to use that as a reference point also going forward, because it's a very, very nice model. And we'll touch in the weeks going forward. We're going to touch on a couple of areas here. And I will talk to those areas specifically. And you might have heard some of the information already, and that's fine. What I find you kind of in this world, it's good to kind of have the information coming through different ways, different wording, different channels at different points of time, so that you kind of they sink in. You might have seen other models. I like this one quite a lot. It's a nice ladder, so it's an easy visual. So you want to climb the ladder from basically down here with the first step and move all the way up. Not everything might be completely applicable to the legal industry and the law firms. But I think at the same time, I think a lot actually is and does apply, and we'll touch on that. And we use that as a reference point. So going forward, we'll touch on single elements here, and I'll kind of point that out again so that you can see, okay, this is where we are, and then you can ask specific questions and get the idea, and we touch on those things. So we start. So you can see here just quickly, the acceptable website. Most companies and firms nowadays have that, though I must say also there's a gap. Yes, some SEO, search engine optimization. Again, that is a long-term investment, which should be there. But it's something which can be time-consuming, costly. It can pay off in the long run, but it's an interesting element of basically of the digital marketing strategy. Then mobile experience, and we'll touch on that, and that's why we use that for this first webinar. And then we have email, we have paid search, yeah, which we're looking at, but it's also the email marketing, which we will touch on in one of the webinars as well. We then move on to display ads. Really, really interesting to see if you really should do that. It's for the legal industry, might not make sense in any case, and really depends also on your size and kind of your marketing, obviously, budget. Then we can move into here the incredible websites, the social media, and then further up the chain. I think that's a fair bit out. And seeing in the marketplace, I think there's only a few who are really, really proficient in that area. It's not that you have to do every single step completely. So there are elements which you can do earlier, obviously, and feel free to ask about your specific situation, and I can talk to that specifically. So this is the letter of awesomeness. Again, we'll use that as a reference point going forward in future webinars as well. So let's talk about mobile optimized websites. And so this is how most websites still look on a smartphone. I'll share with you in a moment after that slide a very cool tool and website where you actually can test yourself and your own website on how it looks basically on a smartphone. What you can see, you can't see too much. You can see the 2014 legal symposium, clearly that. Everything else is not readable. Why is that a problem? Well, 50% of the users are searching on their smartphone. So 50% of the users would find this website. And more people are saying, well, this is actually not acceptable. Yeah. So we have great quality on apps. We have great quality on websites and so on. And why should a mobile website look like that? It's just kind of becomes more and more unacceptable. And it becomes more and more hygiene factor. Yeah. So. And as a matter of fact, then most visitors won't come back when a site looks like that. And they will say, well, there's so much others out there, especially when you think about your industry. You might not get all the all your kind of clients through that through the channel. As a matter of fact, you probably say, OK, most of the most of your clients are coming through referrals. And that's perfectly fine. And that's a completely different area to explore actually how you can use some digital activities to support your referral base, yeah, and what you can do around that. Completely different topic. Still, there is a lot of search for services out there, hundreds and thousands every month here in Australia, and so there is a pool, and I know law firms who actually generate a substantial amount of business out of the internet. So, and then it becomes obviously relevant. And especially when you see kind of then sites like that, it's just kind of, visitors don't like that a lot. And we also will talk somewhere at a later webinar about AdWords. And especially on the mobile, it's really, really interesting to see how much of the real estate, and when I talk about real estate here, it's basically the area of the screen which you can see, and this is the real estate area, so the smartphone screen, and what we will see then is how much actually is consumed by ads. Okay, so this is the problem and the challenge. Then let's take that away and let's see how a site should look like. So this is a mobile optimized website. And what you can see something. Yeah, you can see the logo or even if a video or something like that at the top. You can see, and this is really interesting, call us now for a free consultation, a clear call to action. It's all about call to action. It's about interacting. It's about giving the opportunity to connect with you and reach out to you so that you can talk to the prospective clients and then win them or bring them into the office or whatever it might be, and then take it from there. Then you can talk about a little bit about services. Again, think about the users do not want to have too much information on a mobile. It's on the go, so it needs to be easy. Yeah. Then get in touch. So you can, for example, have here the social media buttons, clearly visual. And again, we'll talk about social media in a separate one. But just to give you any idea, yeah, what is possible, you can also put a LinkedIn symbol, for example. You can leave out the YouTube if you don't have that. So it's very, very flexible. The beauty of that is it's very simple. It's visual on one screen. It's very, very easy to use. And it's a very, very quick fix. So this site is what I call a mobile optimized website. In comparison to that, there are also mobile responsive sites. You might hear that from your web designer, and that's all fine and good. The challenge there is I find mobile responsive sites still use the main content and trim them down almost automatically to a mobile device. The challenge with that is the mobile device actually requires some different interaction and an ease of use, and that's given through with that mobile optimized website. So look, it's a debate. We think this is the way to go, and the clients just love it. They see how simple it is, how easy it is, and whatever kind of the main thing you want at the end. Especially for in your industry, is that the client, the prospective client, is actually calling you or potentially sending an email. Also, that is integrated here, and that's the main objective of the website. So, with that, what I would like to do to show you a little bit more what we do now. We go into the browser, and I show you this one because that's something you can use, and that's an interesting site. And I put that into the chat box here. So it's mobilephoneemulator.com. What does this phone emulator do? Well, it emulates smartphones. So what you can see here. Is basically a smartphone, and you can see here my website. So this is when you type my website into your smartphone, then this comes up. When you have that on a regular site, it looks different, and that's how it should actually look. So and then you can actually really play around with it here. So it's a working model. Yeah. So you have here the touch to call button. You have the email. You can close that again. You can see here, yeah, the about us, the services you can connect to LinkedIn and Google Plus, and we've also integrated here in this case your lead generation for lawyers, the report we are offering, where you just put in your name and email, and then you get instant access to the report. So this is kind of a very simple, easy to use mobile optimized website. What you can do is you can just go, let me show you. Here, let's say, would you mind somebody just type in your domain? What's your website? Just type in your website address, and we'll test and kind of use that as a little test. So, Mitzi, let's take yours. Wonderful, thank you for that. So what you do is, so you go on that page, then you need to say, okay, well, how big is your screen? Type in anything, you can change that any time. Here on the right, you can actually change the phone, the smartphone. So that's an iPhone 5S. You can use different ones if you want. And then you just type in basically your address here, press go. And what that does now, it simulates your website on a smartphone. That's really kind of a nice, neat thing to do. Let's see what comes up. There we go. Wonderful. So this is how it looks like on an iPhone. Looks nice and easy to use. So that's as far as I can even see, mobile responsive, which is great. And let's test it out. Yeah. So let's say who? Yeah. People are always interested in obviously who is in the firm. It takes a little bit longer here because of the emulation. Then, so that's not, yeah. So you can see here, this is actually, I can't on the emulator, I can't scroll. Let me just see if I can scroll. Ah, here I can. Yeah, there we go. There's the scroll button. So that's how it looks. Yeah, so you can see here that, for example, that image here on the top, as an example, for that's relatively hard, difficult to read. So that might be at a first glance something to potentially look at, but otherwise it's really nice. So you can have you see here some information, and then you see basically the information. Yeah, you can read about Jody, and then you can see here the various members of the team, which is really, really good. Yeah. So and gives you kind of email addresses, so it's easy to get in touch with. You even have here kind of ABN and privacy policy and terms of use. So really kind of a very nice good example. And then you can go from here, yeah, and can kind of navigate around that. So for yourself, so what you can do is just kind of go to that mobile phone emulator .com and type in your address, so you can test it out and get an idea how it looks like. And that gives you a very kind of easy to look. So you have an idea what some of the, I'm not saying benchmarks, but comparisons are. And you know, I mean, your prospects, your potential clients, they are comparing. They are looking at what you're offering and how you present yourself. And from my experience, that becomes more and more a hygiene factor. Yeah. So like the standard website, you want to have a website where people find what they are looking for. Similar here with the mobile optimized websites or mobile responsive sites. So I think that's a very, very important and relevant thing. And here with Hive Legal, I think a very nice example how it also can look like. And then you can compare and can have a look at your site. We are actually working on another report at the moment. There is where we're analyzing the top 50 law firms, and there's this you probably might know this competition. We can actually vote for top 50 law firms, so it's not by size. And we are analyzing their digital site, so in terms of social media and mobile presence and so on. And it's really interesting that the majority of firms do not have something like Hive Legal has here. So that's still, I would say at the moment, it's almost still a little differentiator. Very, very quickly, it will become standard. When I talk now to law firms, then obviously either the responsive or the optimized is always a component in the discussions. And again, we'll basically package that in and integrate that. So that's hopefully that's useful, and play around a little bit. You can also use that obviously for other pages, not only for your own business, but you can also just type in Kohl's or Priceline, and you will be kind of shocked sometimes about the quality on the mobile. It's just it's a funny play, and with this tool, I just found that not too long ago, makes it even easier from the desktop, and you can do some desktop research. Great. Let's just kind of move back to the presentation, and that's basically now question and answers. And I see here, yeah, absolutely. Look, it's a very good point, Mitzi, here. The call to action is really, 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 really important. Yeah, it's when you think about it, what's the website? the website is kind of your doorstep. So that's how you present yourself online. And so it's really kind of, this is what people see. And people nowadays, especially when you think about all the distractions which are out there, they need that trigger point. And it's proven that a call to action is actually kind of effective. So people are responding to a call to action. Because if you tell somebody, call me now, then there's a good chance that they will call you if there's a good reason behind that. Yeah. So you can even say, and you do that sometimes, call me now because you get a free consultation. Yeah, or something like that, which makes it even stronger. And here people look around, they see that, and then they read that call to action. And I'll just go back here. Oops, sorry. Yeah, just and again, just on this one. call us now for a free consultation. That's a clear call to action. So when somebody comes here and said, okay, I get a free consultation, I just have to call. And by the way, I only have to press this button. So it can't be easier. And what I see is what a lot of companies are doing. One is that the whole web design thing it has to look nice and whatever. And nice sometimes is then okay. Well, but you use the usability and the user interface with it. Yes, it should. And this one, I think it looks good, but it actually it's purpose. Yeah, it's purposeful. So it does what it should do. It drives the traffic into your office, into your firm, and then you can talk to people face to face and then convert. Yeah. So whatever approach you take there. So this is kind of the steps in the sales process. So and again, when you look at here, so the whole page is actually a call to action. So you have here the first one: call us now for a free consultation. Call to action. Services, okay, yeah, that is some content. Need some advice? Get in touch. Next call to action. Connect with us. Next call to action. Yeah, so you have kind of when you think about the real estate and the use of real estate on the website, you have 50% roughly of the real estate is actually consumed by call to action, and this is what it's about, because you want to connect with your prospects as soon as possible, and whatever they connect, even if they connect with social media, let's say they like your Facebook page if you have one, that's better than nothing. The biggest problem is that people come to your site to say, well, I don't like it. I move on to the next one. Yeah. So you press the back button basically on the phone and off you go. And then they're gone. So I just had a bit of a problem with the mouse. There's another question. Could this page have follow us on LinkedIn button? Yeah, absolutely. So what you can do is have here a LinkedIn logo. Just had a bit of a problem with the mouse that I have to go back to the main screen, but I think you can see that still. So yes, you can put in here a LinkedIn button as well. This was just an example. When I give you, quickly show you something else. And then if there are any other questions, feel free to ask. Otherwise, I want to wrap that up in time so that you can go back to work. We'll just emulate now another one, which is my personal one. Yeah, so here at the bottom, what you can see, you have a LinkedIn button. Yeah, so when you press actually that LinkedIn, that will trigger basically my LinkedIn profile. And then you can also put other links in terms of liked links and so on behind it. So does that answer the question? Well, that takes a while. So that's emulating now. Look, that's fine. Just wanted to show you. So hopefully that was clear how it works. So you can put that logo in as well. So if there are any other questions, Otherwise, thank you very much for attending this first webinar, and I really would appreciate feedback and also input. I have planned out the topics for the next, I think, already 8 weeks or something like that, just to make sure we have something interesting every time. But I'm more than happy actually to obviously to listen to what is important to you. What kind of questions do you have, so I can make it relevant and make it a valuable 30 minutes on a Friday morning, so that you can take something into your firm back and implement that, set that into action and so on. So if you have specific questions or you want to discuss something in detail, please send me an email, michael@dm4l.com.au, michael@dm4l.com.au. Just an announcement, next week, that's the 4th of April, I believe, there is no webinar due to events. I'm attending a breakfast event, so I won't be able to do that. So the next one would be on the 11th of April. I thought I want to kind of keep it on the same spot and time to make it easier. And therefore, we won't have that next week. So, yeah, if there's any other questions, otherwise I wish you a wonderful, successful Friday and a great weekend. Thank you very much.